babies, it's Barbie. On today's episode of Barbie and the Caveman, I'm bringing you something new. Yeah. Now, on the heels of my announcement yesterday, I figured, well, I better figure out something to cook. So here it goes. So, I went to the fish market. Haven't been there in a while. So I came home with some wild-caught, line-caught mahi-mahi. They tell me it's really good. I don't really know how to cook it. So here we go. I've cooked salmon, so I'm thinking it's probably similar to salmon. And it's an adventure. So first I'm gonna start with some strawberries. Now I hopped out to the garden and I found some cucumber, I found some kale, and I found a couple of hot peppers. So I figured, hey, let's use all these strawberries they have at the supermarket, buy one, get one, and we're gonna make some strawberry salsa. So that's what I'm gonna start with. I'm going to chop up the strawberries real finely, you know, like salsa. Add some cucumber, and here we go. Let's see how it goes. So just get a bigger knife. Now, I looked up online kind of how to cook mahi, and it said you can bake it or you can grill it really nicely. So I was like, okay. So I'm going to make the salsa to go over the top. Now there were lots of recipes for some mango salsa, but I don't have any mangoes. But what I do have is a ton of strawberries. So that's what we're gonna go for with next. Go with what you got. So, going to use about this much cucumber. Going to chop it. Desi's very upset that I'm gonna use that much cucumber. So I'm just going to chop it very finely. Now the flavors, of course, of the cucumber and the strawberry work really nice together because, of course, there's the sweetness and the astringentness of the cucumber. Oh no, I might not use all that cucumber. Cucumber is not one of my favorite flavors, but I do really like it as an emulsifying flavor. So, nah, we'll use the rest. So give it a real nice fine chop. And of course, like anything, I am not starting the mahi yet. I am doing the salsa ahead of time because, of course, the longer you get it to come to temperature together and all those flavors to come together, of course, the better it always is. All right, so this is what I have so far. The cucumbers and the strawberries. So then, I grabbed these peppers out of the garden. These are not particularly hot peppers, but I do really enjoy the flavor. And they do smell so nice. So I'm going to chop them up and throw it on in. Yep, and here is a little bit of a sweet pepper. Chop that on up, throw that on in as well. Now, instead of like regular salsa, where I use a lot of tomatoes and salt and cilantro, in a strawberry salsa, I like to use, of course, a lime, but I start with half a lime. So, half a lime going over the top, and then, of course, salt. I mean, can you do anything without a little bit of salt? So, compost that. Some, a couple nice grounds of sea salt. And then instead of the apple cider vinegar, I use balsamic. Of course, it's still vinegar-y, and it's still delicious-y, but with that sweet strawberry flavor, the balsamic really sets it off nicely. Alrighty. So I'm gonna get the rest incorporated and I'll show you the finished product. Hey guys, I'm back and I have used 1 quart of strawberries and mixed it in to that about a fourth of the large cucumber. Now, I also tasted it. This is a habanero. I got my plants mixed up. I thought my mouth was gonna explode. So now I've gotta cool down the salsa. So, how am I gonna do that? Well, I'm gonna add a yellow onion, a small yellow onion. Now, of course, this will, the almond always kind of cool things down a touch. But also, the best way to cool something down when it's just too hot to handle is a little bit of honey. Boom, raw, organic honey. I'll put in about a tablespoon. Now, as I added the rest of the strawberries, of course, it cooled down quite a bit, just diluting it. But, man, was I surprised. I'm really glad that it wasn't rolling, wasn't filming at that point, because you guys would have really laughed at me. So, got my little yellow onion, chopping it up. Yellow onions are so nice. Now, of course, there are sweet onions, there are yellow onions, there are red onions, there are shallots, and I really thought about putting a shallot in, but the yellow onion does add a little more mass, which of course equals a little more diluting of the habanero. So there we go. So here we go. Let's stir it around. Make sure that honey gets nice and incorporated. It's really smelling nice. It is, you can really smell the cucumber, that really aromatic scent of the cucumbers. Well, it's kind of really making a nice little sauce on itself. All right. And it worked. It's now deliciously hot instead of horrifically hot. So yay, that worked. Now, I'm gonna add a little more salt. Gonna add a little more lime, just of course to add some complexity, a little additional complexity. And there we go. Now, I'm gonna pop this baby in the fridge and let those flavors continue to come together. I'm going to wash and scrub my kale that I just got out of the garden. And picked all those stinking little green worms off of the other bunches. I've got no more chard, very little kale, my poor little tomatoes. I went a worm popping. It felt so good. It was really bad, but it felt so good. Stealing my food. The nerve of those worms wanting to eat and go through metamorphosis and such. There we go. Hey guys, so the salsa's now ready and I'm ready to cook up some mahi. Now, by my research says, to pull it out of the package, just throw it on the grill for about 3 minutes, turn it over and grill it again. So, that's what we're gonna try today. So here we go, here's a nice, fresh piece of mahi, and I'm gonna throw it on the grill. It's nice and hot, it's ready to go, and we'll see how this goes. All right, guys, we're ready. Now, let me find the kale. Here it is. Here's the kale. Now, I'm gonna start with, just of course, a bed of shredded kale. For me, because that's really all I want. I'm going to put some kale to the side for Caveman because that's not what he wants, but it's what he needs. And the little egg is gonna be kale-free because that's a fight I'm not ready to battle tonight. All right, there we go. Now here we go on the fish. So a little egg. We'll get a nice piece of tilapia. Mahi. I'm going to remove the scales. He's going to get a strawberry salad. And a little bit of vegetable. Caveman. Okay. We'll get a nice large piece of mahi. Okay, so the caveman will get half kale and half white rice that he loves. Egg is gonna get some tilapia and some white rice and a bit of strawberry salad. Not the salsa, but the strawberry salad. Here's for the caveman. I'm going to put a little bit of sea salt over the top. And here's me. All right, from my family to yours, from my cave to your home, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Barbie and the Caveman, and I'll see you again next time.